Sometimes life is wonderful, and sometimes it's not. Cherish the good, but always be prepared for life's challenges. If your employer doesn't supply health care coverage and you don't qualify for Medicare or Medicaid, you need to give us a call right now. Private health care is private health insurance for ages 65 and under with medical, dental, vision, and even prescription coverage. To get the coverage you need, call the number on the screen now.
Turnpike Sports Book Report.
The Turnpike Sports Book Report is brought to you by BorgataSports.com, your favorite casinos, now your favorite sports book, available anywhere in New Jersey, BorgataSports.com. Sign up at BorgataSports.com using our promo code PIKE, that's P-I-K-E, and you get a risk-free bet up to $300 and 20 bonus dollars at BorgataCasino.com. Must be 21 years or older and in New Jersey to place a bet. Terms and conditions apply. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Okay, for this week's book report, we've got a whole mixed bag of things. We've got numbers to talk about. We got partnerships to talk about. We even have a tech deal to talk about.
Ooh, tech deal.
So let's start off with the numbers. Mississippi reported their sports betting numbers for the month of July. They had a 400% increase over June's numbers.
Okay.
7.9 million in total handle for the month of July.
That, I guess baseball is a big thing about, yeah.
Baseball, and it's just that they're allowing people to go into the casinos again.
Okay.
Too, so,
yeah. Baseball, basketball,
remember,
hockey.
Remember, yep. There's no online in Mississippi.
Yep.
So they got to go to the casinos to do that, and that makes sense.
Okay.
That number is showing the increase in traffic, at least, for the sports books. They had a... Let's see. Like I said, it was a 400% increase over June, and it was a 566% increase over May.
Wow.
I'm sorry. June was 566% increase over May.
Okay.
Then July was 400%. So the percent increase is going down, which shows that the traffic is going up.
Yeah, well, it makes sense.
Yeah,
you know,
they're
things
inversely
are,
proportional.
Things are loosening up, and more sports are being played. So.
And they had a revenue of $1.3 million in July off that 7.9, and that was up from their loss in June. They had a negative 62,000 revenue in June.
Mm.
And they were almost 27% more this July than July of last year.
Okay.
So they've got a healthy growth again.
Sure.
And it's showing that the recovery is going to be slow, to be honest with you. They're not jumping up in numbers just yet, but they are getting there.
Well, you got to wait for the NFL. That's always king in sports betting, and we have to see what happens with college football too.
I have to admit, I think Mississippi was really banking on a lot of college football.
Yeah, I think so. Well, they still might get it. They're not going to get the overabundance of it from the Big Ten and Pac-12, but I haven't heard yet about the SEC, so I think they're still waiting to try and play. I guess they're going to give it a shot. Who knows?
Well, again, I think it's going to be probably good in the long run for a lot of the sports books to have fall and spring football if the college football conferences do it at different times. I think that actually might help Mississippi's recovery a lot.
I'm very interested if there is spring college football, how that would play with the better. Certainly, they're going to be betting on teams, but, you know, it's probably going to be a watered-down version of college football in the spring because, you know, the top talent is going to be saving themselves for the pros, so...
So it'll be interesting to watch at the start. And once the season gets underway, whatever teams are going to be playing, whatever schools are going to be playing, is going to dictate a lot of what's going to go on with the NFL as well, especially in terms of the draft. So, you know, it's going to be weird, to be honest with you.
It already is weird.
And it seems we can't go a week without talking about Colorado. Colorado, the Score, has received authorization to go live in Colorado.
Great.
They have not set a launch date yet. They're anticipating probably by the end of the month, which isn't too far away. But they do have permission to go live in the state. So
you're talking about the end of this month?
The end of this month.
Which is next week.
Exactly.
So
that's what I'm saying. It's not too far away.
All right.
But again, you'll see the Score bet joining the sportsbook industry of Colorado pretty soon.
I say this every week, but I'm very impressed with Colorado. I mean, the growth that state has shown is just absolutely phenomenal.
Well, it's again, they're using a combination model in terms of they're using there's no in-person registration required for the online sports books. They're using the New Jersey model for that.
Smart.
And I think, you know, they seem to have two main centers, Blackhawk being the big one, where everybody's located. So I'm impressed. Also.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Michigan is in the news again. Scientific Games launched their retail sports book at Firekeepers Casino in Battle Creek, Michigan. That just launched, so congratulations to Michigan getting another retail book. And the deal with Scientific Games and Firekeepers, they'll also be launching digital sports betting, online sports betting,
okay,
as well as iGaming when the regulations get passed for those states, for state.
Okay.
So another big step for Michigan. Illinois had a whole bunch of things happen.
Okay, yeah. I guess
Governor
Pritzker rescinded his last order requiring in-person registration, so they're back to you can register remotely online, right?
Basically, he rescinded the rescinding of the
original... Yeah, I'm starting to say that. Yeah.
So, and also, we don't know if he's going to continue that down the road. I think there's an expiration date sometime in September.
Was it September 19th or something like that?
Yeah, mid-September.
Yeah.
Mid to late September. We'll see if he actually continues it. But what I wanted to talk about also was... Illinois had two new sportsbooks open up last week, both Penn National sportsbooks.
All right.
Hollywood Aurora and Hollywood Joliet Casinos both opened up sportsbooks, retail books.
Wow, okay.
They are the fifth and sixth retail books for Illinois. And again, they're about 40 miles outside of Chicago. There's nothing in downtown Chicago yet.
All right.
The one thing that is interesting about this, since they're owned by Penn National, there's speculation that at some point, these are going to be Barstool sportsbooks.
Well, it makes sense. You know, they...
with Portnoy moving down to Philly. And
I guess so.
They're moving ahead with this. It looks like it's going to be pretty good.
I mean, it should be very interesting. That should be a fun sports book to attend. You know, the Barstool should be interesting.
Well, it'll be interesting to see which launches first. I mean, everyone's anticipating it's Penn National. We don't know what state they're going to be doing the first Barstool sports book at yet. A lot of people want to say it's Pittsburgh. I don't know about that. Maybe Philly, could be these two Illinois sportsbooks. We don't know yet, so it'll be interesting to see what happened there. Also in Illinois, FanDuel had a little shift in its plans here.
All right.
They originally had to deal with Fairmont Park.
The horse race.
And what Fairmont did, they filed with the Illinois Secretary of State to change their corporate name to FanDuel Sportsbook and Horse Racing.
All right.
That has not gone through yet.
Okay.
So what they have done now, FanDuel will be launching its sports betting app through Boyd Gaming, Fairmont Park yet. They're through the Paradise Casino in East Peoria. That's their partner. So they're going to be launching online with Boyd Gaming. The deal here was FanDuel was looking to do branding in terms of for their advertising. They wanted to be first in the branding. They wanted to be at the forefront of the branding issues.
Sure.
So FanDuel Sportsbook and Horse Racing would have been perfect for them.
Still might go through, right?
Yeah.
Okay, they're just waiting for it to go through. All right.
What they're doing here is they're going to be second billing in the advertising because it's going to be the Paradise Casino with the FanDuel Sportsbook.
All right.
You know, it's going to be reversed, but they wanted to go first and foremost front and center on the advertising. They may not be able to do it with the Paradise Casino, but at some point, they're going to have two sports books through these two deals.
Great.
Over in New Jersey, we have Esports Entertainment Group partnering up with Twin River to do online sports betting in Jersey.
All right, good.
Now, that's all dependent upon Twin River picking up Bally's Casino, that deal going through.
Okay, so we have to wait on that one a little bit.
Yeah, this was just the announcement of the partnership. And what is also interesting, when Twin River buys Bally's, or if and when they buy Bally's, they're going to be inheriting three online sports betting skins.
Okay.
For Jersey.
Wow, okay.
So there might be three more sports books. One's probably going to be part of this Esports Entertainment Group. You might see a Twin River online book, and you also may see a Bally's online book. I don't know how they're going to work the three skins.
That's a lot of sports books in New Jersey.
Yeah. Well, again, you remember we talked about Tennessee. There's no cap on the sportsbook licensing. Mm. There is a cap on the number of skins that a sports operator can have.
Right now, correct me if I'm wrong, or you might have changed. At one point, I heard that New Jersey has 16 sportsbooks, mobile sportsbooks, so we're talking about possibly more.
Yeah, there's going to be at least two dozen at some point.
All right, I'm officially confused of where to bet.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Okay.
Now let's talk about some of these other deals. Sport Radar has announced a partnership with the Marquee Sports Network, which is the new television home of the Chicago Cubs. They're going to be providing the Marquee Network with broadcast services, including game notes, statistics, the Radar 360 analytics platform, which is an incredible
so
data
basically
platform.
Everything,
yeah, all the data they need and graphics all to go along with it. And one of the reasons why Sport Radar loves this deal is because the amount of history the Chicago Cubs have in terms of statistics and the length of time they've been in the league allows for a huge amount of data that they can create content with.
Great.
And that's part of the deal that they're doing here. Another big deal, PointsBet in the PGA Tour. PointsBet has signed on to become the official betting partner of the PGA Tour, and it's got the same content and marketing deals that, you know, a lot of these other ones have, where they're using the logos, the marks. They're able to advertise not only within the PGA Tour, but also their partner platforms.
You know, I'm impressed what's going on with the PGA Tour. I mean, in terms of sports betting and fantasy sports, they have exploded. And it's a lot of fun. I haven't, before the pandemic, I really didn't bet on golf, or I really didn't do any fantasy sports regarding golf. But, you know, I'm having fun, you know, doing this with golf. Every week it's really great. They have really great tournaments.
Well, the one thing I noticed, a lot of people compliment the NBA for embracing sports betting.
Uh-huh.
I think you got to say the PGA Tour is doing it much better.
Sure.
They're a little bit more aggressive than the NBA, I think, anyway. And a lot of people, this is almost under the radar kind of thing stuff, because a lot of people don't pay attention to golf.
Yeah,
which is sad, because golf lends itself perfectly to sports betting.
I loved when the events with Phil Mickelson and Tiger Woods. I mean, those are great golfing and sports betting events, because it's just perfect. You can bet on each hole as they're playing it. It's phenomenal.
Well, at some point, you're going to start seeing these holes being played, and you're going to see PointsBet's name pop up elsewhere.
On the flags.
Yep. And also, PointsBet and PGA Tour are going to be delivering odds-based content through the PGAtour.com website and the Tour app.
Great.
So there's going to be additional content being produced. And last but not least for this week, we have IGT. This is our tech deal. Mm-hmm. They have signed a deal with Boyd Gaming to provide IGT's Play Sports platform to support all of Boyd Gaming's sportsbooks and sportsbook operations in Nevada. So you're going to start seeing IGT Play Sports kiosks everywhere. You're going to start seeing the brand IGT Play Sports everywhere in a Boyd Gaming sportsbook. So it's going to be interesting to watch. So one thing everyone's pointing out in this is that this Play Sports IGT platform may be a way FanDuel gets into Nevada too.
Okay.
So it'll be interesting to watch what happens there.
And that'll do it for us this week. If you're going out to one of the newly reopened casinos or sportsbooks, please be safe, wear a mask, and we'll see you next time on the Turnpike.